نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد. حدثنا إسماعيل قال حدثني مالك بن أنس عن عمه أبي سهيل بن مالك عن أبيه أنه سمع طلحة بن عبيد الله يقول جاء رجل إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من أهل النجد سائر رأس يسمع دمي صوته ولا يفقه ما يقول حتى دنا فإذا هو يسأل عن الإسلام فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خمس صلوات في اليوم والليلة فقال هل علي غيرها قال لا إلا أن تطوع قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم صيام رمضان قال هل علي غيره قال لا إلا أن تطوع قال وذكر له رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم زكاة قال هل علي غيرها قال لا إلا أن تطوع قال فأدبر رجل وهو يقول والله لا أزيد ولا هذا ولا أنقص قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أفلح إن صدق رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري وحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم يا ربي صلِّ وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم ربي زدني علما. My respected elders, friends, and my honorable brothers and sisters, at this very moment we are sitting in the circle of hadith from the book Sahih al-Bukhari. The hadith which I just read before you, the narrator, he relates that on one occasion a man came to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he was at a distance. He was saying something very loudly because he was a bit far and we couldn't understand and couldn't hear what he's saying. And the narrator describes him, Sa'ir Rasi, his appearance, his hair were untidy, messy. But before I move on and explain the hadith, I just would like to mention that the Sahabi, the narrator describing this person who came to ask Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam about Islam, that he was Sa'ir Ras, his hair were untidy. Why this narrator describing this newcomer that he was untidy, his hair were not combed? Because the Sahaba Ikram, due to the teaching of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, they would always keep their hair, their beards tidy. Especially he mentions that this person who came, his hair were untidy. Because Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam had taught the Sahaba Ikram verbally, practically, that they should keep their hair, their beards tidy. They should comb them. Our Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he himself, he would wash his hair and his beard every day, regularly. And he would apply oil on his hair and his beard every day. This was the sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Ata bin Yasar radiallahu ta'ala, who mentions on one occasion, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sitting in the masjid. He was sitting in the masjid. A man enters the masjid, Sa'irul Ra'si wa Lihyati. He entered the mosque, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam looked at him. He saw him that his hair and his beard was untidy. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam pointed. He made a sign at his hair and his beard. And the man, he understood. He went. And then he came back again. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, meaning he went, he combed his hair, everything. He came back, he combed his beard, he came back. Then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to him, "Now you tell me, is this better? Or you looked better before when you came, as if you were a devil?" On another occasion, Jabir radiallahu ta'ala, who mentions that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to visit us. Now how blessed they were, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam going to their house to visit them. He said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to my house to visit me, and there were a few other people sitting in my house. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw one person whose hair were untidy, they were not combed. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Did he not find anything to dress his hair, comb his hair?" And then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam looked around and he saw another person whose clothes were dirty. And he said, "Could he not find anything to wash his clothes?" Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's the teaching was to the extent that one sahabi, he says that I was wearing very cheap clothes. Very cheap clothes. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to me, "Do you possess any wealth?" He said, "Yes, O Prophet of Allah." He said, "What sort of wealth do you have?" He said, "O Prophet of Allah, I have camels, cows, I have sheep, I have goats." Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed you with all these things, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would like to see the effect of this name upon you. If Allah has given you, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you the wealth, then use the wealth. Allah wants to see the effect of this wealth on you." So the Sahaba Ikram here, when the narrator, he says, this Sahabi, he came while his hair was untidy. Because the Sahaba Ikram, it was the teaching of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that they would always keep their hair, their beard tidy. And the other thing they said, he was speaking loudly. Which is also against the etiquettes of speaking and talking. And the third thing they noticed was, he was saying something but we couldn't understand. This also teaches a lesson. We should say something to people that they should understand. In our conversation, we should talk to people that they understand what we are saying. So he says that this Sahabi who came, he was saying something that we couldn't understand what he's saying. Till he came near, then we came to know that he is asking about Islam. He's asking about Islam. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, he said to him that, he was asking about Islam, so Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, "Khamsu salawatin fil yawmi wa layla." Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there are five prayers in a day and night. In 24 hours, there are five prayers. He said, "Hal alayya ghayruha?" Is there any more praying for me? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Illa an tatawwa." No. But if you want to offer optional prayers, then you may do so. Now, this is the hadith from which Imam Shafi rahmatullah alayh, extracts the masala that witr is sunnat. Whether is now, from this hadith, Imam Shafi rahmatullah alayhi deduced the masala that the witr is sunnah because Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, there are five first prayers in 24 hours, illa an tatawwa, unless you want to offer the optional prayers. Which means that besides the five daily prayers, there is no wajib, there is no fard prayers. So Imam Shafi rahmatullah alayhi, according to his maslak, Witr is not wajib, but it's sunnat. And Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullah alayhi, he says witr is wajib. A man came to Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullah alayhi, and he said to Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullah alayhi, please tell me how many prayers are in a day or night. Imam Sahib said five. He said, please could you tell me, is witr wajib or is it sunnat? Imam Sahib, he said, it's fard, meaning it's wajib. So then he said to, he again asked, he said, tell me how many farids, how many first prayers are in a day and night? Imam Sahib said, five. He said, tell me, is witr sunnat or wajib? Imam Sahib said, it's wajib. So he said, so please can you count for me the prayers? So Imam Sahib said, Fajr, Zuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha. So then he again asked, please tell me how many farids are in a day and night? Imam Sahib said, five. Please tell me how many, is with the sunnah or wajib? Imam Sahib said, it's wajib. And then he left the majlis and he said, you, Imam Sahib, you can't even count. You can't count. I was asking you how many farid are in a day and night. You said five. I asked you witr, is it sunnah or is it fard? You said it's fard. And when I asked you to count, you said five. What Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullah alayhi was trying to explain him, although witr is wajib, but it is tabe, it is follow up of Isha. It comes, you know, when it comes under the Isha. You know, when you say, when somebody has prayed his Isha, if you ask him, where did you go at this time? I want to pray Isha, I've read my Isha. He will never say, I read my witr. He will say, I read my Isha. I'm going to read my Isha. Because witr comes under Isha. And it is only read after Isha. So, but you will ask, how come witr is wajib? Because of other ahadith. This hadith of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is in Tirmidhi and Abu Dawood, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, inna allaha qad amadakum bis salatin hiya khayrun lakum min humrin na'am. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has assisted you with a prayer which is better for you than red camels. Al-witru min salat al-isha'i ila tulu'i al-fajr. Its timing is from Isha prayer till dawn. And our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he recommended for those who could wake up at night for tahajjud prayer that they should offer their witr after the tahajjud prayer. If someone is confident that I will be able to wake up at night for my tahajjud prayer, then he should delay his witr prayer. Then he should delay his witr prayer and he should leave it till end of tahajjud. The last prayer, ij'alu akhira salatikum al-witr. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is saying that they make your last prayer of night witr. Meaning, read tahajjud and after tahajjud, read witr namaz. But those who feel that they were not able to wake up at night for tahajjud prayer, then for them, it is better to read their witr straight after Isha prayer. straight after Isha prayer. So this Sahabi, he asked Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about Islam. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, in a day and night, there are five prayers which are fard. And he said, anything else? Any other prayer? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, no, unless you want to offer optional prayers. And then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to him, wa qala Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, wa siyamu Ramadan, fasting in the month of Ramadan. So he said, hal alayya ghayru, is there any more fasting? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, qala la illa an tatawwa, no, unless you want to keep, you want to observe optional fasts. So then, وَذَكَرَ لَهُ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ الزَّكَاةَ. Then Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم also told him that he has to pay zakat once in a year. قَالَ هَلْ عَلِيَّ غَيْرُهَا. He said, is there anything else besides zakat? رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, لا إلا أن تتوّى. No, unless you want to give optional charity. قال, the narrator, he says, فَأَدْبَرَ رَجُلْ وَهُوَ يَقُولْ. The man, he left the majlis and he was saying, وَاللَّهِ لَا أَزِيدُ عَلَى هَذَا وَلَا أَنْقُسْ. By Allah, I will not increase or I will not decrease upon this. Whatever Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I will neither increase it nor I will decrease it. Now here, the question is, okay, we've understood, he said, I will not decrease. I mean, if there are four rakats in Zuhur, I will not decrease, meaning I will not read two rakats, I will read four rakats. And if in Witr there are three rakats, I will read three, I will not decrease. But he is saying, wala azidu, I will not increase, meaning he's saying, wallahi, I will not increase my ibadat. Taking an oath that I will not increase my worship, this is wrong, this is incorrect. One shouldn't take an oath that I will not do this good deed. So why did this Sahabi, why he took an oath? Because there's a hadith of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in which he says, on the day of judgment, if there is any reduction in our faraid, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, oh my angels, look and see if he has any optional prayers. If there are any optional prayers, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, okay, add these optional prayers with his faraid. So why did he say, I will not increase? And he took an oath, which is wrong. They say, he was a Sahabi of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There is a great difference between our prayer and their prayers. To take an oath that I will not increase my ibadah, this is for me and you, not for the Sahaba ikram. You know, we are offering the prayers, when we are standing in our prayers, our thoughts are here and there. But Sahaba ikram, they were the personalities who were audience of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So when they stood in the prayers, you know, there in their minds was Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nobody else. So it's for me and you that we should never take an oath that I will not do good deeds. This is wrong. But he said, whatever Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has given me in the instructions, I will do it according to that. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he said, qala Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, aflaha in sadaqa. This man, if he is truthful in his statement, then he is successful. Meaning, on the day of judgment, he will definitely go into paradise. So my respected young brothers, the lesson from today's circle is, we should always keep our appearance tidy. We should always keep our appearance tidy, especially those who have been given the wealth of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They shouldn't be stingy. They should use this wealth upon their own selves, other children, and also spend it in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, we should never give up offering our optional prayers. We should never give up our optional prayers. These optional prayers on the day of judgment will be very beneficial for me and you. And also, we've learned from today's lesson that a witr prayer, according to Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah, it is wajib. And those who are the muqallideens, who are the followers of Imam Shafi rahmatullah alayh, according to Imam Shafi, it is not wajib, but it is sunnat. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept this majlis and make it means of forgiveness for myself and all of you. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina wa mawlana Muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi wa barik wa sallim. Rabbi ghafir warham wa anta khayru rahimin. Rabbana hab lana min azwajina wa zurriyatina qurrata ayin wa jalla lil muttaqina imama. اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية في ديننا ودنيانا وأهلنا ومالنا. اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى من القول والعمل والفعل والنية والهدى، إنك على كل شيء قدير. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. وصلى الله تعالى على خير خلقه محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين.